Nothing seems to be off limits to thieves these days, including the wiring that gives us light. Two high school teams learned that the hard way when their Friday night football game had to be postponed.
Well, tonight that game will finally get played, but the incident has some other schools and rec departments looking at the way they protect their lights.
Margaret Johnson joins us live now in Thomasville with tonight's big story at 5 o'clock. Margaret.
Well, Wanda and Cameron, tonight school officials here in Thomasville and Winston-Salem say they're concerned about these copper thefts, but they're more concerned that someone could be killed.
Maintenance crews spent the day at Kushwa Stadium in Thomasville repairing and reinforcing the light box that thieves broke into. They broke the padlocks on the box, used wire cutters to cut out the copper wiring, and when Thomasville and Davy High showed up to play football Friday night, they and their fans were in the dark.
You know how things go if people will take a catalytic converter right off of a car, so I mean, sitting in your driveway, so people get desperate, I guess they'll do desperate things.
What happened in Thomasville has captured the attention of school officials in Winston-Salem. Here at Deaton Thompson Stadium, where Reynolds and Parkland High play their home games, the light boxes are behind locked doors, making it harder for thieves to get to the copper wiring. But that's not the case at all of the fields.
We do have a few stadiums around the county that would be a concern, and that's something we'll be talking about this week.
The thieves in Thomasville only got away with about $25 worth of copper wiring. School officials say their real concern is that the thieves may not be aware of the potentially deadly situation they may be putting themselves in.
If you hit the wrong wire with all that voltage coming in there, it could have killed somebody. So they took a big chance at getting very little money.
It's a very dangerous situation. If the wrong person gets into this box, it could cause some very serious injury.
And Thomasville Parks and Recreation's Director Billy Freeman, the city owns this park here. They say they're looking at other facilities to see if they need reinforcement as well. He says they haven't had any other thefts like this one, and they believe that someone who knows their way around electricity may be responsible for this. The game here tonight starts at 7 o'clock. Back to you.